Hello and welcome to the ServiceNow Service Catalog, Module 4.2. I'm going to talk today about the importance of Service Catalog and just catalogs in general, actually, the different types of catalogs and why catalogs are so important to today's success in any company that wants to compete. In essence, the service catalog is the front-facing component of an organization which displays all the services that are currently available for customers to utilize. So the service catalog contains all the different items and all the different services and the different categories of services, if you will, and within those categories of services, the specific items or the specific services of the category within the service catalog. You can think of the service catalog as the menu that you receive when you go to a restaurant, for example, right? They will present you with a menu where you have all these different items with images and descriptions of the images and details and prices of the different types of foods that they offer, right? So every business in essence should have an effective catalog that explicitly and up-to-date displays information that's relevant to the services that a company provides. But we'll talk more about this in detail, so just hang tight. Okay. The service catalog provides a single source of information on currently available operational services. Okay, so I want you to understand that there's a number of catalogs that you can have within an organization, but a catalog is in essence just one component of what we refer to as the service portfolio. Because what happens is in the service portfolio, which happens to be managed from an ideal perspective in the service strategy phase of the framework, the service portfolio contains three different areas, one of them being the service catalog, which is the front-facing aspect of the business that outlines the description of all the available services to the customers, whether the customers are internal customers or external customers. One component of the service portfolio is the service pipeline. And the service pipeline up here, in essence, is the repository of information that contains services that are being developed or proposed, if you will. Okay, things that may be under the design process or between the design process in or the design phase in the transition phase, right? So it's not yet live service just yet. So things that are coming down the pipeline are what we refer to from a service portfolio perspective as a service pipeline. And then the other aspect of the service portfolio is the retired services, because in essence what we do is we do not delete any information of our database, as I have mentioned before in previous videos. Instead, what we do is we retire the services. In essence, we take them off of the service catalog so that they're not available for the customer to see when they browse through your catalog. But that doesn't mean that they've been deleted from the system. Instead, we retire them and we archive them. And then the reason why we want to do that is because things sometimes come back into style, right? So maybe a service that has been retired may actually come back into the pipeline. And so maybe an example I can give you right now is those Kodak cameras. I was up in Barnes & Noble the other day, and I happened to see, it's like an old school 1970, 1980s, instant camera that would print the image off of the bottom of the camera, $110. I didn't buy it because I don't really need it, but it was just amusing to see, you know, that you have this service, if you will, or this device or this component that's making a way back into popularism, if you will. And so you don't want to delete any information off of the service portfolio, because some of these services might actually become popular later down the road, and we might need to just, you know, do a small adjustment to the information that's already in the system, and then just redeploy a new greater you know, service with up-to-date information. Okay, so this all of this to say that the service catalog is one component of the service portfolio, and that the service catalog is the front-facing component of the service portfolio. Okay, and so what is the service catalog? In essence, it's an ordering system. You know, this is, you have probably seen this before a number of times, because if you've done any online shopping in any website that I can think of right now, you know, that's a commercial website, you know, like if you go to Safeway.com, for example, and you browse through their list of menus and things, you can actually browse through the different, you know, through the different categories of the catalog, and just, you know, order things, and you can actually have these things delivered to your house these days. But in essence, you know, the service catalog provides, you know, an ordering system for the available services and for the products that the company has available for the different department, you know, the users within the department, right? Because in essence, you know, we need to be able to give the users a one-stop shopping, you know, area where, you know, they can go and get the stuff that they need. And so when we're talking about the service catalog, make a side note of this, because there are different types of catalogs, okay? And we're talking here specifically about, you know, a service catalog that provides services to an internal customer in most cases, okay? So we're providing an ordering system for the enterprise organization, so that, you know, if you have, you know, 500 users, 1,000 users, 5,000 users, 10,000 users, it doesn't matter, right? Because the service catalog, if you are within an organization as an IT department, for example, the service catalog is basically the services that the IT department provides to the organization, internal to the organization. So support that we're providing to the VPs, you know, to the booking department, to the financial department, to the human resources, to the shipping and receiving, and so on and so forth. And so those all of those departments are going to need, you know, technical support of various kinds, and they are also going to need the ability to order things that they need in order to conduct their work. So maybe an individual needs a mobile device, or an individual needs a specific software to conduct their work, because they need to do some graphic, you know, adjustments to some videos or images, and so on and so forth. And so maybe, you know, an individual needs hardware that has the capability, the RAM and the storage capability and the video graphics capability and the central processing unit capabilities to perform work that may require, you know, larger amounts of hardware power, if you will, right? So maybe somebody, you know, forgets their password, or somebody's monitor or mouse breaks and they need to order, you know, a new mouse within the organization, right? So this is the individual, you know, the service catalog provides service to the individual departments within the organization. And so this is kind of the basis here for where we stand with this specific catalog anyways, where we are basically providing, you know, the individuals a portal for training in an ordering system, you know, that's broken down into categories that are organized within catalog items, if you will. Okay, and so keep in mind, this is the keep in mind that the service catalog is a piece or a subset of the service portfolio. which is basically a structured document with information about all the life components of a company. And in essence, what we're trying to do is we're trying to create this catalog, make sure that we have all the items in place, and then once the items have gone through a process of quality control, then they can be deployed to the public, in essence, okay? I do want to touch base on this because we are talking here in this lesson about the service catalog, right? And we have two types of catalogs. In this case, this graphic that we're looking at is what we call a two-view service catalog, because what happens is that if I'm the IT department, I need to have a catalog that provides internal services to the departments within the organization, and then in turn, they need to have a catalog that provides the information about the services that each department provides, right? And so as an IT department, you might be responsible for managing, you know, the front facing to the external customers, but also managing the internal facing to the individual departments, which we refer to as an internal customer, right? So this is just another representation of the two-view calendar that may make more sense to you, okay? So in essence, what we have is we have to manage a catalog that provides services to the internal, all right? But we also have to maintain, right, from an infrastructure perspective, the catalog for the businesses that the company actually offers, business services that the company actually offers to the external customers. Okay, and so internally we're providing desktop support, we're providing hardware support, software support, application support, and you know, we're measuring the storage and security of the data as well within the organization. Okay, so this is what, in essence, what the customer is going to see, right? A catalog with a whole bunch of different options where they can click on things and select and add those things to a cart that can then be, you know, put through a process of either approval or, you know, if it's front facing to external customers, then maybe a process of processing financial payments, if you will. Okay, and so the other aspect of a service catalog that we need to keep in mind is that we may be required to maintain a number of catalogs, because what happens is that you're going to have one catalog that provides internal services to the internal departments, but it may be that the external customers are customers that have specific needs, and so we may need to customize catalogs, right? So a good example of this may be, you know, if an external customer that has a business account, right? Maybe we create a different catalog for those individuals that are resellers, if you will, and then we create a different catalog for the external customers and regular paying customers. Okay, and maybe we secure the first catalog password protected so that we create accounts for the individuals, so that we allow additional roles to them so that they can have access to that specific catalog and make orders or requests from catalog items, if you will. Okay, and this is another way of representing the three-view catalog. And then some of these lines are overlapping, because what happens is that we don't have to duplicate the items from one catalog to another. You know, if the two catalogs have things in common, we can actually utilize that one item in one catalog, but also in a different catalog, because you know, there's not, you know, any difference between the way we offer that specific service or that specific item to the external customer. Okay. Some of the key components or concepts that we need to remember here, and I know this is sort of the difficult part, right? You actually have to memorize these definitions. Okay, what is a record producer? And I'm gonna talk more about this in detail, so hang tight. Okay, this is just the textual representation of the meaning of record producers. Okay, but record producers builds the system components associated with the request. Okay, so in essence, it's a tool, right, that we provide to customers that, you know, like a form, if you will, that they can fill information into that populates a new record into a table automatically, so that we don't have to be entering the information manually on our end, right? And we eliminate the data entry on our end, and we make the user responsible. What is an item? An item is the building blocks of the service catalog, right? And those are the actual specifics. So if you went to Amazon, for example, and you went to order, I don't know, a bottle of cologne, well, you know, when you actually open that item and you're viewing the specific item with the specific description, then that's the item. That's what we refer as the item. And then those items may have variables, right? And so variables are things like when you order, say, a pair of pants, and you know, you may have the option for the pants to be blue or black or white or red or, you know, or any other color that's your favorite color. And so we want to be able to give the customer the option to access the item and then make use of the variables to ask for specifics, right? And so we can also utilize those variables to change the cost of the component based on the specific variables that the customer is requesting, okay? And I'll go over that in a little bit. A variable set or variable sets are modular units of variables that can be shared between catalog items, right? And this is kind of the thing that I'm talking about, where you have, you know, you have things that are overlapping that are the same from one catalog to another catalog and to another catalog. And so instead of creating an individual item for the individual catalogs, we create variable sets that can be then shared between catalog items. Workflows. We're gonna talk more about workflows in our next lesson. That's 4.3. So just hang tight, okay? But a workflow is in essence, you know, an infrastructure, if you will. It's the engine within the engine that allows this process to run smoothly by following a specific, you know, linear or multilinear, if you will, in sort of in a mesh topology kind of way, you know, things that need to happen in order to take the service from the moment that the order was made to the moment that the service was received and completed, okay? And so there has to be a process in place into how these items are going to make it from, you know, its non-tangible state of where people are actually making the order to the tangible state where they actually receive the item in their office or in their house or in their place of business, if you will. Okay, but workflows here are really important because they actually communicate the stages of the approval process to the requester, right? So sort of gives you the ability to see, you know, where the delivery of the service is at. And you probably interacted with this before. If you have ever ordered anything from Amazon or any other website nowadays, they, you know, they usually send you a tracking number, and so the tracking number sort of gives you a workflow of when it was shipped, when it was when it's in transit, when it goes through different components of the process of being delivered, all the way up to where it makes it to its final destination, you know, your house. And so once that happens, that record stays, you know, in the system that there was a process that was followed, a specific process. And so if something went wrong, we can go back to that specific step within that process to figure out, you know, why that service hasn't been completed or that service request hasn't been completed. Okay, yeah, I know, it's take a deep breath. But in any case, this graphic here, you know, sort of attempts to represent, to be honest with you, it's a little bit okay. To create an item, we're gonna navigate to the service catalog, and then from here we are going to go to maintain items, and then from here we're going to click on catalog items, and we're gonna go ahead and create a new one. We're gonna call this one an iPad mini, and we're gonna give it a price of $299.99, and we are going to relay this item to the catalog of service catalog, and we're going to give it a category of Apple product, okay. And then we're going to go ahead and add a picture. I happen to have a picture here in my computer, okay. So you go to add a picture. You can import images that are JPEG, BNG, BMP, GIF, JPEG, .ICO, or .CSV. Okay, you can go here to choose file. And we're gonna go ahead and choose iPad mini, if I can find it. Okay, that may not be here. There it is. So we're gonna choose that iPad mini. Click OK.